I'm getting out of here.
We'll bet you and do.
Folks, we're coming back here today.
Go back to the ring, David. Assassin Kai Katana in the ring awaiting his opponent.
Tag team champions, and he weighs it at 412 pounds. I asked him what
with the penthouse playboy Alex Reyes, and he said, I don't want to talk about that. So I don't know what that's all about. These gentlemen won the tag team championship in out of town like about 2 months back. Well, Alex Reyes isn't here, so that's a developing story.
So right now we have Kai Katana, the Asian assassin. We saw him debut 2 months ago, so we're trying to go a little bit. What do we expect of him?
Well, he's a hard hitter. He's got that very scary presence just coming down to him. He's got a big matchup, but Sarah Lee lands on his feet. Oh, a big elbow, or a big shoulder right to the gut, rather.
Hey, look at the athleticism here. That's a clothesline. Drop off of that lift. And sends Kai Katana to the outside.
Absolutely, of course, Kai Katana, he advanced to the second round of the EPWE Heavyweight Championship Tournament. He was defeated in that second
round. Up and over!
And there's Sir Altitude flying. There's no padding outside the ring. Well,
that's absolutely
wooden
not.
Floor here.
Hardwood floor all the way back to the WWF days when they debuted in 1968 in this very location. And Sir Altitude living up to his name. Not even a one count, showing the fighting spirit of Kai Katana, the Asian assassin. Can't deny his heart and determination. Backflip.
This vicious power of the Asian assassin I was talking about. This could be all she wrote. The leg is hooked. Is that going to be it? No!
Someone in our pay-per-view chat said, now, Kai Katana, disregard for the rules, he doesn't usually resort to these shortcuts. Does he feel threatened by the pure athleticism of Sir Altitude Marq Quen?
Wait, let's get back to the Karate Kid reference that was used here on our iPad. The Cobra Kai, they were bad with Mumbo Jumbos.
Mumbo Jumbo, okay.
This is a family show, Mumbo Jumbo.
Into the ropes.
Oh, he's going that size 12, Sir Altitude. From the second rope, he's going to soar high.
Oh, what power here by Kai Katana. He's got him set. Not expect that. Right here, looking at this man. Is that a cover?
The EPWE's bad guy have you with that fallaway slam for that lackadaisical cover. I mean, it was a vicious cover. You didn't hook the leg. You gotta hook the leg.
People are telling you to stop yelling.
Am I being too loud? I am
you are
so
a little
sorry.
Bit too loud.
My parents hated me as a child when I was growing up.
Choking him on the outside. The moment this matchup has swung into the favor of Kai Katana.
And here we have a match of epic proportions as this continues. Am I talking to someone else? Oh, that's a knife edge chop. Back up to my
Can we call the Cobra Kai chop? Can we go there?
Why not? Our fans that are watching, we thank you for watching.
Off the back elbow.
Because they're watching this instead of the NFL. And that's what's up.
For another arrogant cover. Why does he not refuse to hook that leg? To get the extra leverage. And now wrenching on that neck. This is unbelievable. Kai Katana last came in. Last left. I was in the EPWE. We had seen him put on a beautiful display in his debut. Since then, we're seeing a new vicious fight of Kai Katana.
Yeah, when he debuted, when you were with me, I think it was the Koki kid, Sebastian Cruz, who was making his big return to the underground. The Koki kid, a former EPWE champion.
Right in the side of the head, Marq Quen trying to mount some offense here. Go for the neck breaker, up and over.
A little bit of slack to it there.
North counter with the bridge, 2-0. So close, beautiful counter there to that flip over DDT attempt. Kai Katana, great ring awareness, that Northern Lights suplex with the bridge, great in the ring, and Kai Katana's now back on top.
Now the EPWE Tag Team Champion in a lot of trouble here. He's just getting a boot right to the midsection here. These gentlemen, of course, won those belts about 2 months back. It was a big upset, scoring the winning decision over the team of V. Eric Matthews.
And finally, hooks the leg, who's being? Marco Polo says 2 in there. And Kai Katana, I would say this was firmly in control. As Marq Quen had all the momentum in the beginning, and the pendulum has swung into coming out, ripped him by the
and ground and pound and won. And he uses each one of those factors to win a match and take advantage of a match. And he ran a great predicament. And now he's ground and pound, just wailing away on the tag team champion. Of course, Marq Quen and Alex Reyes won those belts over South Philly's finest, as well as Junior Soba and Lee Eric Matthews.
We will see South Philly's finest in action in a four-way tag team matchup. That's coming up. EPWE Underground. Kai Katana now trying to stop Sir Altitude.
But look at this, Marq Quen now. Roundhouse kick right to the back of the head. Could this be it?
Rolls him over, hooks the leg. What I saw there was Marq Quen, obviously under some stress during this matchup, did not extend the bridge to use all of his body weight on top of Kai. But here, he's going up to the top.
This is what he thrives on, y'all.
Altitude from the top.
450 lands on his feet. And now in the corner here, he gets caught up on the shoulders of the Asian Assassin. Oh, he could have
fighting him off. Another neck breaker. Going for it again. Unbelievable.
What a move. He covers him.
Barely covers him. With the left shoulder, Kai Katana somehow, some way, was able to kick out of that moonsault flip over DDT from the neck breaker.
That is just intestinal fortitude from Kai Katana. That was an unbelievable DDT. That backflip added so much impact and force.
Absolutely, the rotation on that. Now, Kai Katana's ramming his shoulder into the midsection. Up and over, he catches him. Kai Katana is big. He is well scouted. Marq Quen here goes for the roll for Marq Quen.
Out to the two.
Oh no! Kai Katana with that core strength.
Wheelbarrow. German suplex.
Unbelievable strength to the nose. Somehow.
The flexibility.
Somehow.
The athleticism of both these young men. We have two rising stars in the EPWE right here. We're witnessing a classic EPW Underground matchup in our opening EPW match. My gosh, what a joint promotion. This is old school, and these two gentlemen are giving us a little flair of what the new school is all about.
This is unbelievable, and we're told from the experts in the chat room that the flip over DDT is a reverse standing diamond. Kick meets the temple, concussion city.
And a Pele kick. Thank you for the chat room advice, and we really appreciate that.
Absolutely, we appreciate everyone tuning in here, and those who join us live from the top, 450.
Nobody's home, he hits his gut first on the mat.
The assassin, well scouted, now he's going in for the kill. Got him hooked in. And now he break binds the legs over, this should be it.
He's got a chicken wing locked in there too.
Absolutely. Does he have what it takes? Sir Altitude. That's it, ring the bell. It's over. It's over. Kai Katana wins. Damon. And he just out-wrestled him.
He did. You gotta wonder if the decision would have been different if his tag team partner Alex Reyes was here. Well, that bottom line is, Marq Quen, he started out, he gave it a run, but he has the Asian Assassin back on the winning ways here. Obviously distraught that he didn't walk out with the EPWE Heavyweight Championship 2 months back. But this could be the road to another title match if he keeps winning, because that's what you gotta do here. Winning equals, yeah.
Winning equals, yeah.
Winning equals, yeah.
So David Adams got to go do your thing, with the ring announcing, and Sir Altitude out there getting his praise. What a matchup that was. We're only two matches in, folks. And don't forget the title match tonight, an EPWE special, Ricky Reyes. First time ever taking on the product, David Starr, for the title on tonight.
Morning, Professor Alpha's coming back.
Oh, get out of here.
Here we go. Professor Alpha joins us in.